Hello, I'm Dr. Erika Sallee, Doctor of Physical Therapy with Readiness Group.
And I'm Dr. Brenda Tillman. I'm a licensed clinician in Texas. I'm an EMDR solution-focused therapist. So the first tool in the resiliency toolkit is something we call Know Your Achilles Heel. What we know about trauma is there are no two people that experience trauma in the same way, and that there are no two people who are going to go through it and handle it in the same way. So determining your Achilles heel is something that is very, you really have to look at yourself and ask, what is it that when I respond to something or a certain response or a certain thing that I've experienced that is going to cause me to have more challenge associated with working it through and being able to figure out, you know, what do I do with this information and how do I not get it to the point where it actually leads me down the road to something more challenging later.
Personalization is a huge factor when it comes to trauma. Oftentimes when we experience an event or a situation that is something we can personalize to our own lives, whether it's responding to a child, a situation, a pediatric situation with a child the same age as a child that we may have at home, or a situation that we've been through in our past that reminds us of that situation. So it's really important. That recognition piece is really the first key step in processing through trauma. You've got to understand how it affects you and why it affects you so that you can do something about it.
So when that's the case, if we are aware of what we're impacted by and what are our triggers, then what we can do is address that and be able to get that plate clear in a way that gives us the resilience we need to go through and enjoy life and find that joy in the future.
Recognition of triggers is really fundamental when it comes to processing through trauma. Most of the time when you ask a first responder, how are you doing? The answer is going to be good. I'm fine, right? I'm handling this great. And so what happens is we end up kind of pushing those situations to the side and stuffing them down and not recognizing the impact that they had on our lives, which then makes it kind of start to bottle up to a point that it may end up negatively impacting us down the road. So it's really important. That recognition piece is really the first key step in processing through trauma. You've got to understand how it affects you and why it affects you so that you can do something about it.
The other thing that you might watch is that chemical experience, because the body responds in kind. When you go into fight or flight, when you go into that red zone, it's a wonderful way to be able to say to yourself, okay, that one might be something that I might need to walk through. Mm-hmm. That one might be something that I need to call and walk through with my person, or even go back to the station or go back to the hospital and talk through with the team that you just experienced that with. Because there's nobody that is a better asset for you than somebody who has walked through an event like that with you. They've mm-hmm. all, and they may not have had the exact same experience, but I guarantee you they are experiencing like things, and the ability to walk through that kind of fills in the puzzle piece process and gives you the opportunity then to think that everyone else is experiencing the same type of things that I'm going through.
And then the third is knowing what to do about it. And that really is key, because when you don't know how it affects you and what to do about it, that's when you often want to run from it. So being knowledgeable and educating yourself on how these traumas might affect you and what your strategy is that works for you to mitigate the effects of those traumas is really key in processing through them.
I just want to end that also with the fact that everybody seems to think when they're going through challenging times that they're the only ones going through that. And recognize, it's really important for us to recognize that we all go through challenging times in our lives. Now what we need to do is see what works for us, because it's going to be different for everyone. Now you get to determine, how do I build that resiliency and some of that upstream stuff, prepare myself, and then what do I do when I really need to turn and address some of the challenges that life throws my way.